Hi everyone, how's it going? My name is Obaida. I'm a software engineer at Facebook and welcome to my channel, CoreSmart. Today I'm going to talk about how to get more interview calls for the software engineering positions in the USA. Have you ever felt like you have been applying for too many job applications but aren't getting enough interview calls? If that is the case, probably this video is for you. I can completely relate to that because I was in that shoes before. When I graduated, I applied for more than 200 jobs, I believe, but got interview calls from only a handful of them. It's even harder for international students like me. I mean, if you don't have the green card or the citizenship, then it's even harder. I can completely feel that. But today's topic isn't immigrations. That's out of our control. We'll talk about how can you increase the probability of getting interview calls by following some simple rules. For the course of the last few years, I went through the job searching process multiple times and landed multiple jobs. Now I'm working in one of the FAANG company. I'm a software engineer at Facebook. So I have developed some ideas like how the job searching works in the USA. So today I'm gonna share my learning or what I have learned so far from my mistakes in the past few years. I hope it will help you to get more interview calls. So let's get started. First thing first, resume. Make your resume stand out and interesting. Many candidates will just fall through the cracks just at the resume screening stage. You have spent years after years preparing yourself on your educations. So why not spend a couple of more hours or maybe a couple of more days on your resume? This is the most important document in the job searching process. The first advice about your resume is make it short. If you are a beginner or mid-level developer, it shouldn't be more than one or two pages long. If you're an experienced developer, then there might be an exception, but I would highly recommend to fit it in 2 pages. If you feel like you haven't said enough about yourself in your resume, then there is always a second option, which is your LinkedIn profile. Go to your LinkedIn profile, add your certificates, your trainings, your courses, etc., etc. If I am a potential hiring manager and I like your resume, then probably I will go to your LinkedIn profile to learn more about you. Second advice about your resume and LinkedIn profile, focus on I, not we. Your potential hiring manager or the recruiter is not interested to learn about your previous team. They are more interested to learn about you, about your contribution as an individual. So instead of writing, we achieved this, our team achieved this, right? I achieved this, I contributed these things to my company. Try to come up with some numbers, some measurable impacts that you can include in your resume or in your LinkedIn profile. Highlight your skills according to your expertise level. For example, if you're an expert in Python, then Python should come first. And if you have working knowledge in JavaScript, then JavaScript should come second. Don't include any unnecessary stuffs or skills like Microsoft Word. When you are applying for a software engineering positions, you are expected to know how to type in Microsoft Word. So don't just include those silly skills in your resume and waste your space. Include keywords. Oftentimes the initial screening is done by machines and machine will look for some specific keywords. And this is true for your LinkedIn profile also. So when a recruiter will search some candidates, they will also search by some keywords. For example, when a recruiter is searching for front-end engineers, you should have that keyword in your LinkedIn profile. Think about potential keywords that you can use in your resume and in LinkedIn profile. It could be front-end engineer, software developer, Python, machine learning, etc., etc. Use whatever appropriate for yourself. Now, one interesting fact about LinkedIn, I personally experienced that whenever I have updated my LinkedIn profile, I got more reach outs from the recruiters. So I think they have some sort of tools to filter out only the recently updated profiles. So I would advise, if you're actively looking for jobs, then update your LinkedIn profile frequently. Make your LinkedIn profile open to work. You can even do it hiding your current employer or recruiters from current employer. And then one crucial thing about your resume, always get your resume reviewed by someone else. As a human being, we have the tendency to overlook our own mistakes. So it's always better to have an extra pair of eyes to have another look on your resume. The next step is the applications, but one more crucial things you need to take care of is the networking. If you're in the college, I would recommend start applying early, possibly in your senior or junior years. Take advantage of career fairs, campus recruiting, conferences, poster competitions, etc. You can even create job alerts in Indeed or LinkedIn so that you won't miss any potential opportunities. And most importantly, make connections. Be involved with the community. Go to meetup.com and find out what meetups are happening near you. It could be anything related to software engineering or related to Python, JavaScript, whatever programming languages you are interested in. I'm pretty sure you will find a plenty of them happening near you. Go to the meetup, extend your network. Oftentimes they will have job announcement. If not, they will most probably they will give free pizza or soda. Connect with recruiters in LinkedIn. Go to linkedin.com and search something, recruiter Facebook, recruiter Google, and try to make connections with them. You can even send some personalized messages to them so that the probability of accepting your request is higher. When you have a big network of recruiters, then probably when the recruiters are searching for some candidate, then there is a bigger chance that he will come under their order. Now come to the holy grail of job searching, especially in the USA, and that holy grail is referrals. Referrals is the most effective tool you can use to get more interview calls. So don't be shy, ask your friends for referrals, maybe friends of friends or even strangers. Ping people and ask them to have a look on your resume. Oftentimes the employees are compensated for referring someone, so this is also beneficial for them. Companies are looking for good candidates and you are looking for good companies, so this is a vice versa situation. Finally, please don't feel low or upset if you got rejections from an interview. This is a part of the process. And keep in mind that you only need only one success, then the failures happened earlier doesn't matter anymore. Every interview you take part in, you will get better in the next interview. Take it as a learning tool. Know your weakness. You can even ask feedbacks from the recruiters and work on that and apply that learning in the next interview. Finally, take good preparations for coding interview. Preparation is the key. There is no easy way, no shortcut, no silver bullet here. You must have good preparations for coding interview. Ask time from your recruiters if you have to. Be well prepared, and I wish you good luck on your next coding interview. I will upload some videos on how to take good preparations for coding interviews, so keep an eye on the notifications of my channel Code Smart. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. If you think that this video is useful, please like, comment, and share with your friends, and I will see you in the next video.